Now we have a very big tragedy. It's called the mitonenim, the complainers. One of the things that Hashem hates so much is complainers. How are you, Moshe? Yeah, tov. He would be good. Meaning now it's not good. What do you mean, yeah, tov? In Israel, it's a very common answer. מה נשמע? יהיה טוב.
יהיה יותר טוב.
טוב, יהיה טוב. הוא told you יהיה טוב, אולי יהיה רע. Now, רבותיי, there is a very big mystery. Very big mystery. Listen, רבותיי, listen to this. ויהי העם כמתעוננים רע באוזני השם. באוזני השם. באוזני השם. Rav Aaron Leib Steinemann Zatzal one time said to his students, do you know what's the number one reason that Hashem does not accept some people's prayers? You daven for 10 years for kids and you don't have. You daven 10 years for shiduch and you don't have. You daven 10 years for money and you don't have. Or for a house and you can't find. Come on, Hashem, 10 years, 3 times every day, it's 10,000 prayers already. How many more times I have to repeat my request? Right? That's how people think. Some people, they stop to pray. Ah, I give up already. What do you mean? If I didn't get married by now, if I didn't have children by now, that means Hashem doesn't want me. You saw the rabbi 88 years old and just have a child? 88 years, and his wife was 50, I think. 50, huh? 58 gave birth. It was a natural birth?
Yeah. It was the
third
time they tried.
Wow. They never had children. One baby was born when he's 88 years old. You may ask, what good is that? In his bar mitzvah, he may not be around. It has to be 101. Maybe Hashem will extend his life to enjoy his kid. Maybe he would live to 110 to see his son even getting married and to have a grandson. Who knows? Hashem can do whatever he wants. But even if Chas v'Shalom he passed to the next world, he passed with a great feeling that he has a continuation. It's already a game changer. Plus, in Shamayim, he will already see what comes out of this child. How much Torah he's going to learn and what grandchildren he's going to have eventually. He's going to benefit from that. But Rabotai, this is, like I say, this is a very big dilemma. So Rav Steinemann say, one of the main, the number one reason that Hashem doesn't accept a person's prayers is complains in life. Complain about his situation. Bitterness. Sad face. You know these people? All the time, sour face. What happened? Better not get into it. I rather not discuss that. What happened to you? Why are you like this? Rabbi, better you don't know. You don't know what I'm going through. In the end, 90% of the time, when you finally get what they're really going through, almost every other person has the same thing. A person chooses what to focus on the good thing in his life or the bad things in his life. Things that he feels fortunate to have, or the things that he's not fortunate because he doesn't have it. In the end, you choose what to focus on. If you will educate yourself to focus on all the great things that Hashem gave you, you have to be always happy, because you have millions of things that Hashem gave you. Gave you eyes, gave you legs, gave you brain, gave you a nice look, gave you health, parents, family, good neighbors, place to live, you're not homeless. Someone sent me this week a picture of the book of the diary of Rav Avigdor Miller Zatzal. There was a whole page that he writes in his diary, thank you Hashem for not giving me. And there was a list of probably 300 sicknesses there. For not giving me heart condition, diabetic, ulcer, for not giving me this, for not giving me that, for not making me blah. Every time he looked at it, wow, how much I owe you. The Gemara says one of the Amoraim was suffering from heat. And in Israel, you know the humidity. So his daughter used to make him some air. You know? In the humid, there was no AC back then. So she made him some air. What will he give her in return? That she stand for 10 minutes and giving him some nice fresh air? He would squeeze for her roses and some jasmine and make her perfume. Women's perfume was homemade. You didn't have all the abomination people from Paris to make up perfumes. People used to make perfumes at home, squeeze some flowers, rose water, all these things, and you know, gives good smell. So he used to squeeze. It took him, who knows, an hour to make her a little bottle of perfume. One time as she's giving him air, it was a huge breeze. Came. Psh, lots of air came. He said, oh Hashem, how much I have to squeeze rose water to pay you just for this breeze. The little breeze she's giving me, I have to walk an hour to squeeze for her flowers. So much air Hashem just gave me, how much I would have to squeeze for a month for this amount of nice cool air that I just got. That's how righteous people think. They take nothing for granted. You walk, nobody owes you that. You're able to see, nobody owes you that. You smell well, nobody owes you that. You taste well, your mouth functioning, your teeth doesn't hurt. You have a stomach, you're able to clean the body from the waste. You know how many people cannot do it? You eat well, you grind the food, you swallow, you enjoy. You're strong, you can climb the stairs. I can give you a list of billions of things that Hashem gave every one of you. No matter how much you think your life is miserable. Billions, literally, of things. Each one of them, if you didn't have it, you would agree to pay millions for it.